Hey there gamers, how you doing? It's me, your boy Waddles, and welcome back to the Minecraft Guide, Crazy Camera Edition. I am fresh off of that beautiful, amazing, ugly-looking zombie spawner farm that we just built in the last episode. The inventory is a little bit messy. I've got to clear out the inventory, but then, after that's done, you already know how we're going to kick off today's episode. Check the level bar. We're all the way back up to level 30 already. That went pretty well. So, first things first, and I'm a little nervous for this, but first things first, we're gonna take this flame and realize that it's absolute garbage. What is going on with the bow enchantments in this world? Seriously, this is painful. This is really painful. Oh, power four. Okay, I take it back. This is not painful. This is good. As soon as we get back up to level 30, that power four enchantment that I just saw is mine. Now, not to be dramatic or anything, but there's a beast in this world, and the beast is a beast that I don't like. The beast goes by the name of the Ender Dragon, and being real here, I want the Ender Dragon dead. I want its head. I want its leg. I want that Ender Dragon gone forever, extinct, eradicated. And to do all of those things to the Ender Dragon, we need one simple tool. Kind of. Not really, but kind of. For the sake of this intro, we need one tool. That tool, Eye of Ender. Eyes of Ender. Eye of Enders. Eye of Ender. Yeah, it's weird to say. Get the dramatic music back in. We need the Stronghold Seeker. To get the Stronghold Seeker, we need two ingredients. Ender Pearls and Blaze Powder. Today's video is all about the second ingredient. Blaze Powder. The Ender Pearls are actually going to be pretty easy to get. My plan is to swing over to a Warp Forest Biome, take out Enderman there. We should get Ender Pearls in no time, especially with his Eluding 3 sword. But the Blaze Powder, to get Blaze Powder, we're going to need to find a Nether Fortress, go inside of it, find Blaze, and take the Blaze away. So, it's time to get geared up for the Nether Fortress, and then go into the Nether. They explore a little bit, find a Nether Fortress, and then check it out. Before we go to the Nether Fortress though, because this is the first time, let's talk supplies. First things first, you need good weapons. This sword, it's not the best, but it'll do, and this bow will definitely help too. The enemies inside of the Nether Fortress are strong. Blaze are bad, you don't want to touch them, and Wither Skeletons, they're just straight up evil. Now, you're also going to want to try and have good armor. This armor is actually kind of garbage for a Nether Fortress, but it'll do. It'll be fine. We'll just have to be careful. Remember your gold armor. It's 1.16 gamers, and the piglins, they don't like you if you don't have the gold armor on. Finally, we're going to want to have extra building blocks. The Nether Fortress could be at an unreachable spot. If it is, we're going to have to build over to it. Also, when inside of the Nether Fortress, we can use building blocks to make the thing a little bit safer. Now, because we're going to the Nether, of course, we're also going to want to bring our flint and steel with us just in case. Our Nether portal is in a super secure spot, way up in the ceiling, but still, you never know. And also some bonus granite. Cool, that's nice. I actually don't really want it, but we'll keep it anyways. And today, I'm looking at the coordinates. 24, 0. That is very, very easy to remember. Now, a Nether Fortress. We're looking for a big fortress built out of Nether bricks. I have zero lead on a Nether Fortress. No clue where one could be. Okay, that was cheating. I totally hit that one. I don't know where a Nether Fortress is, which means we need to start today's video by exploring. Now, where haven't we explored? Well, that's actually pretty simple. We barely went into the Soul Sand Valley biome in the Nether exploration video, so I'm thinking we start here. We'll try and move across the Soul Sand Valley, and maybe, if we're lucky, we'll find a Nether Fortress and we'll go check it out. Also, the gas, you despawn. That's exactly what I thought. I was gonna say no gas are getting away from me today, but guess that's already kind of not true. Now, if you're looking for Nether Fortresses, one tactic is to go along the lava ocean and look for the legs that come out of the lava ocean. I would do that, but there's no easy way down, and I'm kind of terrified of lava ocean, so what we're going to do is just move across the land. I haven't seen the land, and I'm kind of curious anyway, so no big deal. Now, when moving through the Soul Sand Valley, we definitely want to keep our eyes on the sky for the gas, but also the eyes on the ground, because skeletons exist here too, and they're almost just as bad as gas. Now, what do we have over here? Anything cool? Oh, a skeleton. Speaking of, we're just going to go ahead and keep moving. Nothing so far, though. Wow, that's a little bit of a bummer. But then again, it's only been like a minute, so kind of understandable. How about over this hill? Maybe another fortress over here? No, just a ghast standing and not even looking at me and shooting. Okay, that's cool. That's cool. They're like evolving, and I swear, I keep shooting at these fireballs, right? And then the arrow goes like right through them, and now there's a skeleton literally behind me? That's wonderful. Seems fair. Alright, so we have a Crimson Forest biome over here. Haven't really checked that one out, and ideally, I'd like to not check it out. If I could just keep moving through the Soul Sand Valley biome, Honestly, I'd be cool with that. I kind of like the idea of that a little bit more. The Soul Sand Valley is a whole lot more open and honestly easier to travel, unless the Soul Sand Valley biome ends, which it honestly might. Yeah, there's a lava ocean down there. We could definitely move across it, though. It looks like if I were to go over that way, I could go across that land bridge and maybe continue on, which I think is what we're gonna try. Oh my gosh, you move so slow in the Soul Sand Valley. It is painful. It's really, really painful, but it's cool. As soon as we hit the soul soil, we cruise until we hit soul sand again. But look at this. All of this soul soil, I literally can't be stopped. Now, what do we have over here? When you're looking for another forager, you're going to want to stop and check your surroundings every once in a while just to be sure you don't pass it up. This is a sweet view. The Crimson Forest looks really cool from this spot right here, not going to lie. But, you know what would look even cooler? If that Crimson Forest has another fortress inside of it. Alright, we have another big open spot. Lots of falling, that's not fun. And then, no nether fortress. Also, not fun. Double not fun. Not good. Now, this right here is kind of the end of the Soul Sand Valley, I think. Unless it continues on the other side, which it doesn't really look like it does. Yeah, now we have a big drop and lots of Crimson Forest. So, what do we want to do here? How do we want to move through here? Well, this would be really tough to navigate. We could make a bridge over to there, but that would be kind of tedious. So maybe what we do instead is we backtrack and actually change our course. What if, instead of going that way, we go this way? We just need to be really careful and watch out for big drops. And now that we're in the Crimson Forest biome, we need to watch out for the Hoglins. Hoglins have this crazy knockback. They'll send me literally flying off of a ledge, and they'll also deal a lot of damage to me because I have iron armor on. Iron armor, not the best with the Hoglins. Now, I'm thinking that maybe we just keep moving this way. I want to try and avoid going back towards spawn. I've been by spawn. I've kind of seen a lot of the area by spawn, so maybe if I go the other way, I'll find something a little more interesting. Stay back, beast, stay back, you savage. Okay, we run. Oh, no, you run because of this. They don't like the blue mushrooms. Haha. All right, we have a Hoglin sighting. This Hoglin is close too. We're gonna have to take this Hoglin out. And if we take this Hoglin out, this will be the very first pork chop of the world. Do you drop any pork chop? You did. Thank you very much. This is a special piece of pork chop that I will save your... for not very long. I will probably trade it out for loot that we find inside of the nether fortress. If we find another fortress. I'm still moving through the Crimson Forest biome. I keep finding a lot of cool views, but no sign of a nether fortress quite yet. Now I do know that the 1.16 update, or maybe one of the later ones, like 1.16.2, or maybe it was the first one, I don't know. One of the 1.16 updates actually made nether fortresses a little less common, which is definitely a huge bummer for us today, but once we find one, it'll be great. And then once we get inside of the nether fortress, everything's gonna be really, really easy. All we need is something like 32 blaze rod, and that's actually a pretty low bar. 32 blaze rod, definitely achievable, considering the fact that most nether fortresses have blaze spawners inside of them, and the blaze spawner will continually spawn blaze. Alright, so our first tricky area to travel. This could be tricky, but also, it probably won't be too bad. We want to be careful here, though, and be smart. So, let's go. Okay. Retreat. We wanted to be careful. We wanted to be smart. Now we need to stop burning. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to hold down on this eat button on the stake. Maybe I'll stop burning now. That would be great. Okay. That's a little too close. Yep, don't touch the lava. Don't touch the lava. Lava big bad. Anyways, I was saying we want to move right through here, so we're just gonna block the lava off very, very carefully. And we're not gonna ever touch the lava. No, I would never do that. And now we can actually just jump down here and keep walking. Boom, easy. No problem at all. Never. Doesn't suspect a thing. Silly beast. Doesn't even suspect it. And we drop down for the final kill. Boom. Look at that. That's some pro moves right there. Now we are back in the Soul Sand Valley, or so I thought. Maybe not. Maybe not quite yet. We'll have to go around this mountain, maybe. Then we'll be back in the Soul Sand Valley. All right, Soul Sand Valley. Here we and Nether Fortress. Here we are. Okay. There's a gas, and there's a big hole on the ground right there. Big hole on the ground. We're out of here. You know what? No, you're out of here, gas. That's what I meant to say. You're gone. It's over. I may have to hit you so many times, but you're gone. Terrible fortress. We're not even in it. We went the other way. But okay. I mean, hey, that's sweet. Okay, now we're gonna backtrack this way and go right into that nether fortress. How far are, well, you know what? First things first, let's just get over to the nether fortress. Wither skeleton right away, terrifying. Another one or two more, also terrifying. This is a long ways from home, and there's Blaze sniping me too. Here we are, negative 600, negative 200. Yep, pretty far, and also spicy, definitely spicy. All right, so first things first, we're gonna wanna make a secure and safe and easy way into this place. I think all of those can be tackled by making a staircase out of cobblestone right here. Pretty simple. We'll just go in at this end of the fortress, and then we'll be able to go out right at this end of the fortress as well. Now, I think the staircase is probably going to end up running right into the fortress, so we'll actually get to steal some of the nether bricks, which is pretty cool. Might as well take some of those while we're here. Nether bricks are actually, seriously, one of my favorite building blocks, even though I, like, never use them. I think they look so cool. I just love the texture, the dark tones, and everything. They are honestly the OG Blackstones. Nether bricks confirmed OG Blackstone. You heard it here first. So here we are at the top of the mountain, inside of the fortress now, actually right on the side of it. Take some of those bricks, thank you very much. Now we need to find Blaze, those guys right there, and take them out. That should actually be pretty simple. Now, while we're here, we're gonna find a lot of wither skeletons too. Those are the guys that we really have to be careful around. But if we're lucky, because we have looting 3, or just in general if we're lucky, we could get their head. And then, if we get their head, we could actually get more of their heads, and then we could spawn a wither boss and get a beacon, which would be really, really cool. But there we go, Blaze Rod, and there's even an advancement for it too, which is pretty sweet. Now, Nether Fortress survival tip. Wither skeletons are tall. If you do this right there, boom, wither skeletons can't get through, but you can. You still will have to watch out for the Blaze and any other enemies that spawn in this place, though. So, I just saw a couple wither skeletons over this way. Let's go ahead and try and move over here and take them out. That would be really... and a Blaze spawner. Okay, well, yep, that's how we're gonna get all the things that we need. That's gonna make our life really, really easy. Wither skeleton. You gotta watch out for these guys. They deal the wither effect. The wither effect makes your health kind of hard to see, and it basically drains it. It's honestly kind of like poison V2. What's wrong though, wither skeleton? Why are you too tall? Oh yes, you're way too tall. That's exactly what I thought. And honestly, knockback is kind of nice with wither skeletons. With wither skeletons, the best tactic is really range. If you can keep them away from you, you're probably better off. But it's also usually best to take the wither skeletons out with your sword. If you have looting on your sword, that is. So what do we have over here? Is this a dead? Yes, it is. It is a dead end. Now, if we wanted to stop wither skeleton spawns and skeleton spawns, we could actually start lighting this place up. Same with blaze spawns. But I actually don't really want to stop any of those spawns. I'm fine with those spawns happening. If those spawns happen, of course, then I can actually take out the wither skeletons. And if I take them out, then I have, again, the chance to get a wither skeleton skull. Something that I definitely would love to have. But what we will do to keep this intersection clear of other hostile mobs is place a torch down. Then we can basically charge the spawner, take out the blaze to spawn around the thing, grab the rods, and back up. We need to do this until we have a half stack of blaze rods, which actually shouldn't be too far off now. Let's check it. 12. Okay, we're like almost halfway there. That's not bad. Now last season, we actually ended off building a blaze spawner farm. That's something that I 100% want to do sooner in this world, because blaze farms, like the ones based around the spawners, are actually like really, really good for experience. Now blaze, they are very, very dangerous. They shoot fireballs, but also they deal a lot of damage if you touch them. Definitely do not touch the blaze, ever. The most damage that a blaze deals in a single hit is when you touch it. If you're lucky like me and you find a blaze spawner that's cornered off inside of a room, something like this one right here, here's the tactic. Wait for a blaze or a couple blazes to spawn, charge the spawner, take out the blaze as fast as possible, again, don't touch it, and then get out of this space. If your health starts to get low, definitely get out of the space. Retreat, eat a little bit, then move back in there. Now we have another one down the hall, which is definitely going to be annoying, so watch this. Boom, big sniper moment right here. You go away, blaze. Goodbye. You didn't exist ever. Don't charge the blaze spawner unless your health is basically full. Charging the blaze spawner with a low amount of health, very, very dangerous. Also, try and take out the fire around the blaze spawner too. Now, we are in a sticky situation because they've cornered me in. You let me through here, thank you. If we get in a bad spot, pull the bow out, take the blaze out. But we've got the looting sword, so ideally, I wanna take the blaze out with my sword. The blaze rods will have a better chance of dropping and better drop amounts. So what do we got right now? We have 31. Ooh, we are close. Okay, a couple more blaze rods and then we're gonna be set for good. Then we can go ahead and check out the rest of this nether fortress. Oh man, there's a lot of blaze up here. Oh man, you know what? It's bow time. You're all gone, you don't even exist, and we have more than enough blaze rods for sure. Now, the reason we went for so many, really, just to be stocked up, so we're good for a while. So, now we're back over here, kind of where we came in. What I'm gonna do at every crossroads is basically place these block barriers. The block barriers will make the crossroads super safe for me. Something that I really like the sounds of. Okay, this one's kind of a weird intersection. Check this out. We have a hallway, and then we have this kind of weird staircase room, and then boom, more nether portals. That's kind of interesting how that joined together like that. Now, can we maybe find the inside of the nether fortress? Most of the loot lies inside of the fortress. These are really just the bridges. The bridges are cool, but if we're looking for loot, which I definitely would love to have some of, we're gonna need to find the inside. That's not gonna be the inside. Okay, backtracking this way. Oh, some wither skeletons spawned right there. You know what? We're gonna go ahead and set this blockade up right here, and we're gonna take on the wither skeletons really quick. Maybe this time we'll get a skull, if we're lucky. Maybe? Please be lucky? No. Okay, well, we'll try again. Please be lucky this time. Right there. Oh my gosh. We're lucky. We're lucky for sure. We're lucky. Okay. Okay. We're lucky. Yeah, wither skeleton skull. That's pretty sweet. Okay. Not gonna lie. Pretty impressed about that one. Pretty hyped about that. That's sweet. We're lucky. We're lucky. What can I say? What can I say? Now, Blaze, you are annoying me. You are like really, really annoying. Go away. Wither skeleton. Come. Come. Come here, friend. Come here. The torches in the offhand are getting really annoying. I keep spamming them everywhere, but I want to leave them in the offhand so you guys can actually see things. All right, though. Time to move inside of this fortress, which means maybe down here? Maybe? Or is this just going to be more... I think this is more bridges. Unless... That looks good. That looks like it's the inside of a fortress. Okay. We'll put more barriers here just so we're safe when we're coming back. And we're heading this way. Now, nether fortresses are gigantic mazes. You definitely don't want to get lost in these things. If you have to, put markers around the fortress. For me, these are kind of my markers. Torches would be great, too. Now, we are officially inside of the nether fortress, and inside of these hallways is where we find the loot chests. Maybe we'll get really lucky and find a loot chest right away. Okay, maybe not, maybe not. But maybe we'll find one at least somewhere. Also, I think I see a stairwell. Maybe this will be a stairwell with, oh, a loot chest. Okay, that's cool. I was going to say nether ward, but a loot chest is great too. Some gold armor. Absolute trash, but we'll take it anyways, and we'll actually break this chest so I don't get confused in the future. We're going to have to trade something though. Let's go ahead and trade, I don't know, a block of gravel. We don't really need that. So, oh, hey, even more loot. You know what? This is a good intersection for this little safe space too though. Let's go ahead and build one of those, and then let's check out that loot. What do we got? Ooh, lots of gold. Lots and lots of gold, actually. Well, I will definitely take it if you put it that way. Oh, but you know what I also hear? I think I hear like angry piglins, maybe. They're just gonna have to deal with it. All the loot is mine. Hey, 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 speaking of loot, we have even more loot. Boom, moo, diamond horse armor. I was gonna say, where's the diamond stuff at? Thank you very much. Now, we're gonna have to start getting more selective here because we're running out of space. Saddle, you come with me. Stone sword, lay on the ground. Chest, you know what? Yes, 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 I definitely want the chest. All right, so chest, thank you very much. And now we go this way. Let's go down this staircase. Maybe this will be a nether ward room. No, maybe not. Okay, well, maybe. Nether ward room right there. This is the nether ward room. One of the only sources of nether ward in the game. Perfect. We're definitely gonna take this stuff, we'll bring it back home, and we'll be able to grow it. You can use this stuff to make potions. And hey, I think, oh, I know. Basalt Delta, boom, another fancy advancement. That's the last nether biome, and it's linked to this nether fortress. That's great. If this is the closest nether fortress to our nether portal, I'm gonna be a little bit bummed. But at the same time, at least we have a nether fortress, and it's via Basalt Delta's biome, which makes it even better. Now let's check this loot. Ooh, diamonds. Perfect. Okay, now what do we drop? What do we not need? Well, I kind of wanted the gas tier, but I guess, you know what? Gold sword. I don't want the gold sword. And I guess a bed. Minecraft bed. Don't need you in this dimension. All right, so we need to go back up that staircase right there to leave, so I'm going to put a torch there for now. Let's go ahead and go down this hallway and see if we have any more loot. We definitely do. We have at least a... Ooh, there's a lot of loot in this fortress. This is amazing. All gold swords, though, at this point, they're getting left behind, and unfortunately, a lot of horse armor will probably get left behind, too. It's okay, though, because we'll come back. We're actually going to probably just dig a tunnel to get home. That's going to be the easiest way to get home, and then we can come back to this fortress at a later time, maybe when we're making like the blaze spawner farm, and just take all of the loot back home with us. All right, so we've got another Wither Skeleton down this hall guarding the loot. Let's go, Wither Skeleton. Me and you, and a zombified piglin too. Okay, we're gonna need to be careful with that. We definitely don't want to anger you. Could you just run away, child? Please run away. Thank you. You don't want to see what's happening here anyway. Loot, what do we got? We got something good? Ooh, gold ingots. That's what I'm definitely not talking about. That's not good, but we'll take it. All right, so I think I've explored all of this hallway system. There are some chests inside of these hallways with loot inside of the chest, but I really can't do anything about it. I hear a Wither Skeleton. The Wither Skeleton is close. Where is it? Is it... I feel like it's down there. How about... Oh, there you are. There you are. You come right back with me into the trap. You've fallen for it. All of your kind, small brain. Another loot chest, though. Haven't checked this one out. Diamonds? No. This stuff. Maybe I saw that one. But look at that. Another nether wart room, and I've actually cleared up a little bit of inventory space. Nether warts, you're all coming with me. I don't have any at home. And hey, would you look at that? I found the exit to this place and a ruined portal. Do I want to go check out the ruined portal today? No, I actually don't. Sorry to disappoint. All right, so now we need to find our way back out of this thing. I think I've actually checked out most of the hallways inside of this thing. It's a little hard to tell. Here's the exit. It's a little hard to tell, but I'm pretty sure I've covered them all. Like I said, if you don't care about cutting out spawns, place torches down as you're exploring this thing, and spawns won't happen. If you place torches down, then you'll definitely know where you've been and where you haven't been. But I think, and I want to say big thing here, that I've cleared the Nether Fortress good enough for today, which means it's time for us to actually move back home. Now, to get back home, I have a different plan. To get here, I basically ran however I had to run. That worked, it was good, but it would be really hard to trace my steps back home. So, instead of doing that, what we're gonna do is build a staircase right here up into the ceiling and then just dig a long tunnel home. Sure, it'll cost my pickaxe quite a bit, but it'll be a whole lot easier to get back here in the future. And hey, I mean, you never know. Maybe, big maybe, we'll get lucky here and find ancient debris. If we find ancient debris, ooh boy, we'll get to bring that stuff home with me. Now, I think what I'm gonna do is move all the way up to like 110. 110 should still be in the ancient debris range. Not 100% sure, but if we go up to 110, we should get to dodge most of these big open gaps right here. We should be pretty far up in the ceiling to the point where the ceiling stays the ceiling. 110, boom, here we are, which means it's time to dig a tunnel. Now, which way do we need to go? I think we need to go this way. Yep, we need to go all the way back to about 00, approximately. So I'm gonna dig a long tunnel this way, slowly like this. You wanna dig these really, really slowly just in case lava. And then we're gonna turn the tunnel. I think it's gonna have to go probably this way. Yep, it's gonna have to go that way. And then I should link up pretty close to the Nether portal room, like the actual room itself, which will be kind of cool. But I am like 700 blocks away, so that's gonna be a little bit of digging and it's gonna take some time. Oh, and every time I find this, I'm gonna use my cobblestone and make a bridge. Hopefully I don't find this too much. Anyways though, I'll be back once we're back home. Do you hear what I hear? Probably not, but do you see what I see? Oh yeah, we made it home. Now, while I was making this whole hallway, I actually ended up going a little bit higher than I was just because I kept finding like these gigantic gaps. They were kind of difficult to travel across, but we have made it home. The Nether portal is now linked up to the Nether Fortress. It was a long dig, a really, really long dig, but I've done it. And we have a very, very nice trophy to show. One Wither Skeleton skull. That is literally crazy. Honestly, can't believe we have this thing. We're gonna put it in this chest with some super, super valuable stuff. Now, the rest of the inventory, it's very, very messy. We need to clean it up a little bit, and then I think we have a big appointment that we cannot miss. Definitely not. So I thought today's question of the day would be kind of fitting for this episode. Instead of a question, it's more of a statement. The comment was about the How Did We Get Here achievement. Now, I wanted to use this comment to talk about achievement, something that actually, for some reason, I haven't really mentioned in the series quite yet. So, by default, the keybind is L on Java Edition. If you press the L key, the advancements menu opens up. Minecraft has a lot of different advancements. These advancements sort of guide you through the game. Now today, we got a couple nether advancements that were pretty sweet. One of them was for traveling to all of the nether biomes, this one right here. Another advancement, this one too, this one also. Yeah, it was a pretty good day for advancements. If you ever don't know what to do in the game, maybe you're stumped, check out the advancements. The advancements will sort of guide you through different features and mechanics in the game. So right here, here's like the main advancement run here. We start right there, and then we go all the way to here. We need to beat the dragon. Now, as you can see here, we've gotten a lot of these advancements. Maybe, just maybe, I'll have to make a shield. I would like to set a goal. Maybe, in this world, depending on how long we actually end up staying in it, we'll try and get all of the advancements. But that's kind of a challenge, because some of the late game ones are really, really tricky. But I guess we'll see. Now, the appointment that we definitely can't miss, it's over here at the enchanting table. Power 4 bow, you are mine. Oh my gosh. Okay. Power 4 bow, that's not it. Unbreaking 3 infinity as well. Goodbye, OG infinity bow. I won't get rid of you. I'll use you, maybe, probably not, but wow. Okay. This bow is the start to a really, really good bow. Power 5 on this bow, maybe flame on it. Okay, yes. Yes is all I can say. With that though, that's gonna be the end of this episode, elites. We will definitely be going back to the Nether Fortress and talking more about them in depth, different mechanics, different farms later on in the series. Today, big shout out to my patrons, Dark Panther 7, Anti-Goose, and Nathaniel S. Thank you all so much for the support. Drop a like, subscribe if you haven't subscribed quite yet, check all my links, they're down in the description below, and if you're into merch, I've got that too. It's down below the video. Stay fresh, it's been me, your boy. Goodbye, everyone.